Good morning, everybody. Why don't you stand to your feet with us this morning? Let's worship the Lord in this place. Are you glad you're in the house of the Lord this morning? Oh, that wasn't very good. Are you glad you're in the house of the Lord this morning? That's better. We're glad you're here. We're glad to be here. Come on, sing it with us.
We wait for this day. We're gathered in your name, calling out to you. Your glory like a fire, awakening desire, will burn our hearts with truth. You're the reason we're here.
Yes, you are.
Amazing grace.
Yeah,
sing it out.
This is amazing grace.
Oh my Lord.
your name.
Can we just keep giving him praise right now? Lord, we praise you this morning. We glorify you. We honor you. We thank you for your grace, your mercy, your love for us. Today we celebrate that. We thank you for these moments we have to lift our lives, our voices in worship. You are worthy. Today, come and fill this place with who you are. Lord, may not one of us walk out of here the same. May we leave changed and different because we've met with you, the Almighty God. We open our hearts to you right now. We say, Lord, have your way in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. It's going to be an awesome day in his presence. Let's welcome Jesus right now. Amen. And then we're going to welcome our guests, Kana's Voice and Jaron Davis. Let's welcome them this morning. We are excited to have them with us, leading us into the presence of God, and that's their heart, to just simply lead us there, not to be the spectacle, not to be the entertainers. They are here to just worship with us, and we love that about them. It's going to be an amazing, amazing service. We just experienced one before. We got a little preview, and it was awesome. God's going to do great things as we open our hearts and allow him to do it. Amen? And so today, just do that. Just be ready. They're going to share some stuff. They're going to sing some stuff. It's all going to just touch different people's hearts in different ways. And that's the great thing about music. It has a way of ministering in a way that the spoken word doesn't. It could be the same words, but put to music. It's just something stirs. The anointing just touches you in a different way. So today, I know you're going to receive something. Our goal is that you would be touched by God. You'd see him. You'd feel him. You'd be changed by him. And I believe that will happen. So this morning, we'll hear a little bit from them a little later. I want you just to take time to say good morning to someone around you. If you don't recognize a face, introduce yourself. Welcome them to church. I'm going to invite our altar workers to come. Our prayer partners will be here across the front and in our balconies as well. We have some new prayer walls in the balconies where you can find those and write a prayer need, put it in the prayer wall. We have intercessors, prayer partners praying throughout the week. We have Sunday evening prayer, and we pray for these needs. So if you have something that's just burdening you, that's heavy in your life, don't face it alone. Don't walk it alone. Yes, Jesus is with you, but we can have the power and agreement of our prayer partners and those that love to pray for needs throughout the week. So avail yourself to that. If you have some kind of need in your life, there's power as we just come and leave it at the feet of Jesus. So as we continue to worship this morning, Kana's Voice is going to lead us. And today, if you have a need, we know he has the answer. Amen. So today, I'm going to just challenge you, as we worship, if you have a need, bring it. But more than anything, forget about people around you. Forget about anything that's happened before you came into the room today. And just determine in these moments today, you're going to receive what God has for you. That you're just going to open your heart and say, Lord, whatever you want to speak to me, whatever you want to say to me, whatever you want me to sense or feel, whatever you want to change in me, I give it to you right now. If we do that, I know amazing things will happen. So let's just open our hearts and continue to worship today.
Just want to acknowledge you, Lord, because without you, we're nothing. In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter,
Our hearts to you this morning. We're desperate for you. Meet us where we are.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. So we pour out our praise.
and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing.
Some of you came in here this morning and you just don't feel like worshiping. You don't feel like giving up any part of your breath for him today. You're just tired. Listen, just because we have microphones up here doesn't mean we don't feel the same way. Some of us came in here this morning carrying burdens. You came in here this morning just not even in the mood. You were drugged here by your spouse or your parents or your family. But maybe what you need to do this morning is to cry out to God. Maybe you need to give a sacrifice of praise today. Maybe you need to just get whatever you have left in you, whatever small morsel of strength you have, whatever small amount of attitude you can muster. And you need to look up at the heavens and say, great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Tell him he's great and greatly to be.
Sing that again. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise.
It doesn't belong to you. It never did. Every breath we take is a gift.
It's your breath.
He takes and gives as he sees fit. So the minute that we think we have the strength to do it, that's the minute that we fall. Because every breath we breathe is His. So why not give it back?
It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath.
Heaven. sing hallelujah. The Lamb is over.
Amen. Oh, he is forever worthy of our praise. Whatever you brought in here today, whatever you're walking through, listen, you can leave here a different person than when you walked in. And not because you came to church, not even because of Cana's voice, but because the presence of Jesus is here. And he is forever and forever and forever worthy to be praised. Man, God is so good. Do you sense his presence this morning? Man, I sense the presence of the Lord. Let's just thank him one more time. We worship you and praise you, Lord Jesus. You alone are worthy of all of our praise. Man, God is good. You can be seated if you can in the presence of the Lord. What a great day. We've already sensed and felt the presence of the Lord. I want to thank you for coming. If you're visiting with us, I'm Shane Wilson. I'm the lead pastor here at the church, and I'll tell you in advance, I'll let you in on a little secret. We're not a perfect church, and I'm certainly not a perfect pastor. You probably just ask a few people in the lobby, they'll let you know. But we're crazy about Jesus here at Christian Life Assembly. And we're watching God week by week transform hearts and lives. And so we're thrilled that you're with us. Our prayer for you today would just be open up your heart and let the presence of Jesus step in and do something really miraculous in your life. Your decision to follow Jesus will be the best decision you've ever made in your life. And maybe there's somebody here today, just feel compelled. You've tried everything in the world. You've tried everything to cover over the pain and to soothe and medicate the pain. Let me just give you a challenge today. Give Jesus Christ a try. I promise you he'll make a difference in your life today. Not tomorrow, not next week, not today. He will change your life today, in this moment, in this place. He does this incredible exchange. He takes your junk and he gives you peace. He takes your mess and he gives you hope. He takes all of your past and he gives you a fresh, clean start. That's what Jesus will do for you today. Don't leave here today without inviting Christ into your life. Man, God is good. I'm gonna invite our ushers to come. A couple of announcements. Baptism on April the 22nd. We've had so many people give their heart to Christ in the last few months. I just encourage you, call the church, go to the website, sign up for water baptism. Also on April the 22nd, we have a Mission 10 offering. We're trying to fund, or we wanna fund some of the projects that we've committed to for this year, from El Salvador to Africa to Alaska, different missions trips. And so I just pray that you would pray between now and April 22nd, ask the Lord what he would have you do, and then just obey. He'll take care of the rest. After second service today, informational meeting about our Tanzania trip, so I encourage you to take part in that. And I want to brag on our students for just a minute. This is not about the money. This is about the principle of giving, because our whole life is about giving back to the Lord. You know, in March, we raised money, or our kids raised money through Change. They collected Change, Buddy Barrels, BGMC. Our students in Change collected over $5,500 for Boys and Girls Missionary Crusade. What an incredible thing. But more than the dollar amount, again, it's the lesson of giving, of sacrificial giving, even at a young age. I want to thank you for Easter. Wasn't last week just an incredible week? God transformed many lives and hearts. I want to specifically thank the hundreds of volunteers that you don't see. They come long before you get here. They stay long after you leave. They're behind cameras. They're behind lighting boards. They're at the welcome centers. They're turning on lights. They're cleaning and emptying trash cans. Could you thank those hundreds of volunteers that make it possible? It's an honor to do ministry alongside of you every week, and the Lord's been praised, and we had almost 4,000 people on Easter weekend last weekend. Just incredible. Had a couple thousand watch us via stream. I don't say that for any other reason other than those people heard the gospel of Jesus Christ, and lives were changed, and hearts were transformed, and that's what it's all about. It's not about numbers. It's about the kingdom. And so we give back today so that we can continue to do kingdom work. And so let's give back with a cheerful heart and in an attitude of worship today. Lord, we love you, and we don't own any of this stuff we have. It's all yours. We just steward your blessing. And so we give back today with a heart and an attitude of worship. And we know that you'll do what only you can do. You'll take the gifts that are already yours. You'll multiply them, expand them, stretch them so the gospel can go around the world. We love you. And we praise you in Jesus' name. And everybody said, would you welcome back Cana's voice this morning?
Every day, oh, Heavenly Father, you're the one we're with. welcome to my right, Mr. Doug Anderson. To my left, Mr. Jody McBrayer. Yes, on the piano we have the incredible Jaron Davis. My name is Taranda. We are Cana's Voice.
Yeah. Heavenly Father, you're the one we're waiting on. Because without you, there's no way that I can stay strong. I can't go on any longer on my own. So
hear me when I say,
Heavenly Father, we need your help today.
Yes. Come on, Doug.
Yes, sir.
I believe that with just a little bit of love and a whole lot of Jesus, we can still change the world. Amen?
When she walked in the room, she would be rejected. It would be better for her to just stay outside. Well, this woman's a sinner, the Pharisees whispered, but Mary refused to hide. As she knelt at his feet with tears pouring out, in a room of accusers she found
love anyway. His heart beyond the past, deeper than scars, fierce and courageous, bold and unafraid. Love anyway.
So many people you meet every day are so wounded. Lives intersect for a reason that we may not see.
Come on, Jill.
You could be the light in the darkness they're fighting,
the kindness they desperately need. So don't miss a moment, no, don't turn away. When you feel like leaving,
stay. Your heart beyond the past, deeper than scars, fierce and courageous, bold and unafraid. Love anyway.
And at the end of the day, none of us deserve it, but at the feet of Jesus,
what it's about. It's about love, right? God is. So we're supposed to be. Now five of you answered that. I can see I'm going to have to come down here because some of y'all are looking a little sleepy. So can you put your hands together with us? Come on. Here we go. Listen.
Oh, I breathe. Because you give me breath and I walk. Because you are my steps and I sing, yeah. Because you are the melody. Yes, you are. And I am, cause you say that I am. Could it be that
you're the reason I live, the reason I love, the reason I always have enough. You're the reason I laugh, the reason I smile, the reason I'm standing all the while.
You're the reason. it's true that all my reasons are you. Now some of y'all don't even know what to think, and that's okay, because we're gonna praise the Lord, and that's what this is all about. Oh, you are the meaning of it all. You just speak,
you just,
and make the nations fall. You dance,
you,
yeah,
dance.
I like that. And all creation moves in place. You are faith, you are hope, you are.
Very much.
That is awesome.
You may be seated.
These are the leaders of tomorrow right here.
That's right. I actually want to see that
Did
dance.
Did you see
step,
me try?
The bread,
no, my
stick,
daughter's
right?
Trying to teach me. So I don't know. Is it called? What's it called?
Breadstick?
Dabbing.
The floss. No, it's called the floss.
The floss?
Oh my gosh. Dab is so 5 years
out.
Ago. It's the.
Oh,
it's
sorry.
Like,
no.
Careful.
I really want to see that.
That was fun.
So are you guys, you're the youth group, right? College and career or youth? Like high school? High school.
Ah, they know
I was
the
cool
floss.
When I was in high school. Now I just have a belly. Thank you for participating. You guys are awesome. And seriously, nothing lights a fire in a church more than a youth group that's on fire for Jesus.
That's it.
So let it shine. Burn this place up for Jesus. I ain't even playing. It's awesome. What are we doing now?
Let's take them back. Let's do it.
What?
Let's take them back. Let's take them back to old him.
Oh, okay.
Well, okay. We can do that. We've changed everything up.
Okay, folk.
Okay. So give us the lower key, Jaron.
I always do.
Oh.
That was really good, though, how you just did that. Do that
That's
one more
nice
time for
chord,
the people.
That's a nice chord, Jaron. I liked it.
I worked on it.
Go ahead. Man, oh man.
It's talent.
That gift right there. Do you know Jaron Davis? Are you familiar with Jaron Davis? Well, let me brag on our friend Jaron Davis for just a second. And I'm not gonna brag on you for what you think I'm gonna brag on you for. I'll get to that. But this morning has been a hard morning for Cana's voice. Specifically for me. I just could not get my stuff together this morning. Anybody ever have a morning like that? I mean, can we be real? Is this church? Can we be honest here? I mean, this is supposed to be a hospital, right, Pastor? Instead, it's not a museum. I don't want y'all sitting out there folding your arms trying to figure us out. This is a place where we all come and we're honest and we get healing, right? So this morning at first service, I was having a hard time. And Jaron, who is much older and wiser than I am, came back to the pastor, which pastor, thank you for letting us use your room back here, by the way. We kind of kicked you out. I'm sorry. But Jaron came back and in his fatherly, godly way, spoke words of wisdom that I don't even think you knew I was listening to. But I love you. And more than your gifts, I appreciate the man of God that you are and how you speak into our lives. This man right here wrote the song Holy Ground. You know that song, right? We are standing on holy ground. You know what? Can we do that right now? Why don't you tell them about it and then have Taranda tear it up and...
I was just a teenager watching the youth group over there. Really excited me because I was just a teenager when my dad asked me to do something at the church and to write a song for the first Sunday service we were going to have in our new building. And I put it off and put it off and put it off. And I'm so glad, God, even when I procrastinate, God can do more in my last minute than I could do in the 35 days in advance that I should have been doing it. And I'm glad that he doesn't have an age limit on what he will use. You can't be too young and you can't be too old for God to use you for his glory. My dad asked me to write a song for the first Sunday service in a new sanctuary we were building, and I put it off and put it off, and finally on Saturday night at midnight I sat down and wrote the song We Are Standing on Holy Ground. And many, many times over the last 37 years since I've written that song, God has used it to bring back to my remembrance the fact that wherever I am, even if it looks like I'm in a bad place, wherever I am, if His presence shows up, it becomes a holy and a hallowed place. It becomes hallowed ground. And I want Taranda to sing the second verse. And maybe some of you are in a place right now that it doesn't feel so holy and it doesn't feel so special. But I want you to know, because you're there, you're the apple of God's eye, regardless of what the enemy or other people may have told you. And I want you to know that today in His presence, this is holy ground. And right in this moment, you can reach out and get your answer and claim it, because He is here in this place. Come on, Taranda, sing it.
In His presence, there is joy beyond all measure. And at His feet, peace of mind.
Praise you.
In and out of situations, the tug of war at me. And all day long I struggle for the answers that I need. Then I come into your presence, and all those questions become clear. That sacred moment, no doubt can interfere.
Sing it if you know it.
I was thinking of something else. As you'll see up here, what you see is what you get. And sometimes that's really good. Sometimes that's really good, and to be honest, y'all, sometimes we mess it up a whole bunch. But the heart is, our heart is to do whatever God would lead us to do. And we've been through our troubles just like everybody else. But the thing that we keep preaching on and on here lately is everything falls at the name of Jesus, because every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord of all. And there is no problem too big that God cannot solve it. And there is no mountain too tall that he cannot move it. And there is no storm too dark God cannot calm it. There is no sorrow too deep that he cannot soothe.
Upon his shoulders,
If he carried the weight, sing it.
If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulders, I know, my sister, that he will carry you.
One more time.
It's all I've ever wanted to do is sing gospel music. And I got the chance when I was 18 years old, and I joined a group called The Greens from Boone, North Carolina. I fell in love with the lead singer. We got married, and 6 months into our marriage, he was diagnosed with renal failure, which is kidney disease. They told him in 6 to 8 weeks he would need a transplant, so we started asking everyone to pray, and everyone started praying, and God sustained my husband with no treatment for about 8 years. During those 8 years, we had 2 children that they told us we most likely would not be able to have. Isabella is now almost 14, and Josie just turned 10 on Monday. When it came time for a transplant, I was tested to give him a kidney, and I was a perfect match. They said if we'd been born twins, it would have been a closer match. In 2009, I gave Tony a kidney. In 2010, he developed a lung disease that his body couldn't fight, and God took him to be home. I was 30 years old, 2 kids. No idea how to move forward. No idea how to wake up alone. When Tony passed away, I lost my best friend, my husband, my children lost their father. He was my boss. He liked that most of all. I couldn't figure out how to do life. I moved in with my parents. My mom helped me take care of my kids. It was so bad that one day my mom took me to the doctor, and through a series of tests, the doctor diagnosed me OCD, psychotic, which I found out does not mean psycho, probably. Severely depressed. 4 medications a day I took just to get through. After several months of taking those medications, I realized it wasn't working for me. Thank God for those medications. Thank God for doctors who can prescribe things to help us. Amen? But those were not working for me. And the short of it is, I found myself looking in the mirror and not even recognizing myself through decisions I had made, terrible decisions I had made, and things that had happened to me. I didn't even recognize myself. For the first time in a very long time, I started praying and I said, God, I know I'm not being who you created me to be, and I know I'm not acting right. But God, I don't know how to do this. I don't know how to be a single mom. I don't know how to make a living for my family. I don't know how to be here. I don't know how to do this. God, I need your help. When I finally surrendered to the Lord is when my life turned around. And let me tell you today, your story may not be mine. You have your own story. We all do, right? But we're all going through life together. And if I can encourage you today and let you know that God is faithful and that Jesus has you in the palm of his hand, and he won't lead you astray. You can trust the Lord. All these years later, I'm depression medication free. And God brought a wonderful man into my life. My last name is Green. His last name is Bean. So what does that make me? We have a blended family now, which brings its own set of issues. But every day we're trusting the Lord. And I have the privilege of telling you that Jesus is indeed right for everything wrong in your life. And I have the privilege of telling you that when everything else in your life is failing, when you can't see the sun, when you don't want to get out of bed, when you don't feel like praising God, there's one thing you can count on. And that's that Jesus never fails. So many souls have tested him throughout the course of time, and so many still reach out to him with broken hearts and minds.
And every one of them will say, with no exception, that they find Jesus never fails.
He never fails. And even in the days of old, he brought his people through. Then he came to show his love, and he died for me and you.
Then he rose again to that every story has been true. Jesus never fails. Jesus never fails. Jesus never fails. You might as well get thee behind me, Satan. You can
not prevail, because Jesus never fails.
Sometimes this world's gonna bring troubles that we find so hard to bear, but I know I could not make it without Jesus being there.
So encouraging to know, however deep we're in despair,
Jesus never fails.
Oh, so what can I do to prove?
Almighty. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? Listen, have a seat. I heard somebody say a million times, I used to travel on the road with a group called Truth, and the director of the group Truth told his story, and then he would say, "You'll never know that Jesus is all you need until he's all you've got. And then when he's all you got, you'll realize he's all you need." Some of you have been walking out this life without him, spending your days struggling against life. I'm not saying that Christians don't have struggles, but the difference is Christians have hope. If you're a Christian and you've known Jesus for a long time, or even if you're new, raise your hand. I want to see you. You see these people? If you can't raise your hand, look around at these hands. These people have found hope. They don't walk this life wondering what's going to happen when they die, because they know to be absent with the bodies, to be present with the Lord, they're going to spend eternity in heaven. But not only that, while we're here on this earth, we have a Heavenly Father that adores us. And he is here for every single trial that we face. We would be very, very selfish if we did not take a minute to share with you, if you've never prayed a prayer or you've never accepted Christ, how to do that. Because as far as I'm concerned, more than choosing your spouse, more than choosing where you're going to live or where you're going to go to church, even more important than where you're going to have lunch after church. It's the most important decision you'll ever make. I know some of you are like, more important than lunch? Listen to me. If you don't have Jesus, you need him. And the great thing about it is, if you don't have Jesus, he wants you. He loves you. Oh, but you don't know me. You don't know the things I've done. You're right, I don't. You don't know the things I've done. But the great thing about Jesus is, he says, I don't care. See that cross? Everything that you've done, I took care of it right there. Right there. Every heartache, every pain, every sin, every struggle, every frustration, every question that you have, I bore it and I will bear it for you, because nobody is a friend like Jesus. So this morning, I'm going to pray a prayer. It's a simple prayer because I don't believe the gospel's complicated. I think God meant it to be simple. He sent his son because we weren't worthy and we were full of sin to die on a cross and save us from our sins. He was the only one whose sacrifice would be enough to pay the price for your and my mistakes. So he did it. But the great thing about it is, like Cece said last night, and I love it, 3 days later, he got up. He didn't stay in that grave. He's the only person in history to ever conquer death. And that same power wants to love you. So if you've never prayed that prayer this morning, now's the time. I'm going to ask everybody to pray this together. Even if you've accepted Christ before, I want you to say it loud, and I want you to say it strong, and I want you to say it proud, so that the people sitting next to you who maybe have never prayed it, first of all, so that they won't be scared. Second of all, so they'll see that you are proud to be a Christian and you're proud to stand up for Jesus Christ. So let's all pray this together. Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I know that I have made so many mistakes. There are times that I feel unworthy, but your blood makes me worthy. Your sacrifice allows me to come to you. So today, I ask you, Lord, to forgive me of my sins. I ask you, Lord, to come into my heart. I ask you to save my soul today. I love you, Lord. Thank you for hearing my prayer, for loving me enough to sacrifice yourself for me. In Jesus' name, amen. It's not hard. Yeah. It's not hard. If you prayed that prayer this morning, the Bible says if you believe with your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and was raised from the dead, you will be saved. If you prayed that prayer this morning and you've never prayed it before and you believe it, you're a Christian. You're going to spend eternity with Jesus. And you know what else? You got miracle working power on your side, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Can we give the Lord a shout of praise in this place this morning? Hallelujah! Woo! Bless the Lord God Almighty.
I was waiting for them to sing again. Let's just sing one chorus. We are standing. Stand with us. On holy ground.
Jesus. Yes, we are standing in His presence. Oh, we are standing in His presence on holy ground.
Can we give the Lord one more hand of praise today?
He is worthy.
He is worthy.